So, I've got a cute craft. So, if you guys have heard of Vintage to Chic, I got some papers from her. We're going to use some stencils, and then the print we're going to use is this right here. Isn't that so cute? And then I thought, because it has a cowboy boot in there, we're going to use some butterflies, and then we're going to use the horseshoe from my Totally Dazzled Royal Funky Junk pack. And then we're going to be making over this. I got this at the Goodwill for $4, I don't know, a couple weeks ago. It's just something that hangs on the wall, I guess like a mailbox you could stick your mail in, or magazine rack, whatever you want to call it. So anyway, we're going to paint this. I'm going to use the linen paint from Plaid. I like this linen color. And then I'm going to use some of this pale, it's called Pleasant Pink. And I'm just going to start, like I said, I'll do the back later. I'm going to start painting and I'm hoping that this is going to be light enough that pale pink goes okay. And I'm hoping I didn't prime this. I'm hoping I don't have to put primer on it. So now I'm going to paint the inside first so I can hold this up. So let's give this one more coat. I'm hoping one coat does the trick. Okay, so I think this is all done and dry. Look at how pretty. See, total makeover. So now what I want to do, and I'm going to lay some paper towel down. I don't want to scratch it. I want to put a stencil on the side. Okay, so now I've got this stencil. It's just like a harlequin. I'm going to lay it up here. I'm probably going to have to stand up. I'm going to try to get it squared up right to the end so it looks nice. Kind of nice and even. And my goal is to take this pink. I think I'm going to try the swirl method. Okay, so I'm just going to dab in here with this pink and just say a prayer. And I know they say offload, offload, offload. And now this is not an essential stencil, so I feel like I should just dab. Oh, let's try swirling anyway. I think we're gonna lose, right? Everybody said swirling the other day, and let me tell you how much better it worked swirling than dabbing. I need a little bit more. And I think the pink is gonna show up okay. Okay, ready? Not too shabby. There's a little tweaking needed, but only on the one that I see. Other than that, I'm not gonna complain. I'll take it. You know, perfectly imperfect. You just dry it, because we're gonna have to flip it over and do the other side. And then I'll show it to you guys. I can even sand this off a little bit to get those edges down and kind of smudge it. But look, I think it looks pretty. Right? See the paper? It kind of flows. So we're gonna do the same thing. Oops, I stuck it right in paint, guys. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other side. But look at that, there's one side. So see, I got a couple of goofy looking pieces, but I could touch those up. I mean, if I really wanted to do that now, I could take like just a brush. I've got some of the tan paint, and all I would do, this is how easy it would be to fix that, is just kind of clean it up with some of the tan paint and just kind of go over like here on the sides, maybe a little bit. So now on the inside here, just along this back wall, I want to do some stripes. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to grab my big ruler, just a flexi ruler, and I'm going to kind of like find the center, or attempt to find the center, And I'm gonna grab a pencil. Pencil is actually sharpened. And I'm just gonna draw some lines because I want to do the pink stripes in here. I didn't want to do Harlequin because I think it would be hard. And like, so now I got stripes, so we're just gonna finish off the other side. Let's see how easy. And I like the thickness of these stripes. And just using a pencil. And it looks like I got it pretty. I think I did a good job eyeballing that one. Okay. So see how we just have the stripes in there? I just want those to be stripes. So all I'm gonna do is grab my, take my pink back, and I'm gonna grab like a bigger brush, and I'm just gonna try to get down there. And again, guys, don't sweat it. If the bottom down here doesn't look that great, seriously, don't give yourself some grace, because it's kind of hard trying to get paint all the way down. There we go. And I'm trying to go like right over my pencil lines. It's just awkward because we're going down into a box. So while that dries, let's get our image on. Now I know our image is not gonna go all the way to the sides, but if anything, I was thinking we'll have these dots. I can probably blend that out with maybe some pink and stuff. You know how much I love to blend. Now the only thing I am gonna do is I am going to water cut this, because I don't want, actually I'm only gonna water cut the sides, and I'm just gonna get rid of that white edging that's there, because we don't need that. And it doesn't have to be perfect, I just wanna remove that white edging. I'm gonna use the Posh Chalk Pigment Infuser as my decoupage medium. It's like my new favorite decoupage medium ever. And we're going to put this right here on the front. And again, this is Posh Chalk Pigment Infuser. So good, so good. It's really great. It's not thick like Mod Podge, and I truly, truly love it. And I'm going to attempt to just center this, kind of like so. I want to get those boots, though. At the bottom of those boots is where I want wind is blowing. And I'm just going to press that down. And being that that's a nice flat surface, then you can just kind of go in. Because I got my, you know, my fan on, it kind of dries faster. Just work with it. And that's where I'm just gonna press everything down. All right, now I'm gonna grab a sanding block. And all I'm gonna do is just kind of shave this paper off right there. Oh, you'll love this. Look at how stinking pretty that is. Tell me all about it, y'all. But I am gonna go now, and I'm just going to seal this paper down. Make sure you get, you know, all the way around it on all those edges. I'm even going to go all the way to the edge, just because in case when you use wax, wax will look differently on something that's been sealed than what hasn't been sealed. So sometimes I'll even go over and do the whole thing. You know, and looking at it, it's like, do we really need to seal it with dark wax? I'm afraid that dark wax might change it, but let me see. Let me hold it up. I think dark wax will give it more of this hue, so let's try it. Okay, so let's just see what dark wax is gonna look like. with my clear combination here, you know that I do. Let's just give it a whirl. You don't know until you try, right? And I'm only gonna go in with a little bit of dark. I'm not gonna use a lot. This is the Bare Wax from Home Depot. Let's do the bottom just to see, because that's gonna be the most inconspicuous spot there is. I'm just going, and plus the wax is really going to seal that chalk paint, so it almost is like a necessary thing, you know. So see, it did warm it up. See, I knew it. See how it just now it matches the background beautifully. So let's continue. It is such good wax. So now I'm gonna do the sides. And so you just brush it on. And I mix the clear and the dark. And I'm even gonna go up here over to the edge of that paper. I don't wanna go on top of the paper just yet. And then you're gonna find a clean part of your rag. See, that kind of modeled it up, which I'm okay with that, but you can even take, oh, and you can even go like this and stuff that up, which I like that antique-y look better. Yeah, it's really pretty. So then you're just going to do it again. So as you can see, we have this, oh, look at how pretty. Y'all, there it is. Now, what we wanna do is we wanna add that gold in there, okay? I just wanna stripe, I wanna clean up those stripes, so now is when I'm gonna go in with some liquid gold and skinny brush, like so. Okay, so I'm just gonna attempt to get down here the best of my ability at the bottom, and I'm just going to, jeez, I probably should put this down. I'm going to attempt to go over that pencil line with this brush. And that's going to clean up the lines and it's going to hide. It's going to hide. See how I did that? It's going to hide the pencil marks and it's going to hide the wonky shape of the brush. That's my page. So see, we just did the gold. Isn't that pretty? Okay, so now, because I only have one of these little nubs and I filled the holes in with hot glue before, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna show y'all, you wanna make sure your space is level. You know, I'm gonna make attempt to recreate this just with hot glue, but you want your surface to be level or your glue when it's hot will drip. So I am going to make sure this is all clean, okay? And just hold your glue like perpendicular or straight up and just, and then give it a whirl. They might be a little bit bigger than that one, but who's looking? I could use cabochons, but I think they're more humped where this is gonna match that. It's more of a flat dome. So I'm going in, I thought about using the cabochon. I have some, the half wood beads, but I think the shape is wrong. That's more of like a dome. And then you just gotta let this dry. I'm gonna keep it up there and I'm gonna paint this one because we are gonna paint these gold. But you don't wanna touch those until you absolutely know, matter of factly, that it's dry. And you can tell it's dry when it starts to turn clear. And then you're just gonna go in with this liquid gold, which liquid gold you can find at Michael's, you can find it, I don't know if Walmart has it, you can find it at Hobby Lobby. It's on my Amazon store for if you're like me and you don't like to go anywhere. So see, we painted that one, came up perfect. So that's perfect. All right, so see, you can see how these are getting cloudy. And when they get cloudy, they're good. And that's what you want. You don't want to paint it before that cloud comes on. And you don't want to use a heat gun to paint them because they are hot glue. So then you just can go over here and you just paint these. And see, we have our little nubs. Can you tell which one is the real one and which one are the glue dots? We need to seal it. I do want it to be shiny. So, and then we're gonna add bling. So this is triple thick Duraclear mix, 3 parts triple thick to 2 parts Duraclear. So the great thing about triple thick Duraclear is that you can go over the liquid gold, you can go over wax, you can go over things, but it's gonna give a beautiful, I don't even know what to say. It just gives a gorgeous, gorgeous like sheen. And if you back. Okay. Now we're gonna dry it, and now we can start blinging. And you see that beautiful, can you see that beautiful sheen? It's just super pretty. Now comes the blingy bling, 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 bling. All right, we're gonna turn this on its side. So I got some pink stones and the totally Dazzled Ultimate Rhinestone Applicator Kit. You get these little trays, you get your picker pen, you get B7000 glue. Now I did go ahead and order a huge jar of B7000 glue because not gold, we're going in with pink. These are like a pale pink stone. They have a ton of colors that you can use and purchase from. And I'm gonna go in on each tip where those harlequins interconnect. And I just drop a little bit of E6, this is B7000. You get your picker pen. I'm gonna have to stand up, y'all. Can't see diddly spot. And you want it to be flat because OMG, this is so pretty. I'm all about the bling, y'all. Ever since I got my Totally Dazzled Ultimate Rhinestone Applicator Kit, I can't even tell you. It's all I do. It's all I do. Show you. Right? And then you want to let that sit for just a few minutes to that B7000 glue like holds so well. But there you go. Look at that. Now I don't want to put this down on that end and do the other side. I want this to really dry. So I'll do that after the live because I really want that to gel up. I want to add my horseshoe. Okay. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to add in some rhinestones into here too. So all I'm going to do is lay it down and see where these like little horseshoe holes are. I did this before on something. So if you can get your stone just to even sit in there. So I'm just kind of like gluing all around the outside of that hole just so the stone has something to latch onto. And you're never gonna see the glue. So we got our little horseshoe. As you can see, I filled it up with the pink sparkles. I am gonna use a little bit of hot glue and some B7000, and I'm just gonna set this right up in the front here. So I'm just gonna attempt to put some B7000 on the horseshoe and then a little bit of hot glue because that's what's gonna give it immediate hold. And then I'm gonna try to find the center. Plop it right in there. So cute. Let that dry. And then you can find some other bits and pieces of, you can add, you know, we'll do a little bit of pink. I'll probably do a little bit of white flowers, maybe some green bling. I mean, there's so much you can bling here. So let's just like take these little roses right here, these little rosettes, and you can just take and add like a little bling flower right in the center. Just sparkle it up. And there's so many different sizes available and colors. So see, we're just adding little bits of sparkle to the flowers of the print here. Why not? Yeah, so I'm gonna bling all this up, but I wanna keep that down and let that glue dry right now. Oh, I wanted to add a butterfly on here because I thought that would look pretty. You know what, let's do gold. Gold matches a little bit more, and I do have this really pretty one in gold. Why don't we do one big one and one small one? I think I wanna put this little one here, maybe up here, and then take this big one and put it up here. And then we're gonna have all those little blings everywhere else too. Yeah, so I'll spend probably another hour blinging this up using the Ultimate Rhinestone Applicator Kit, just adding in the sparkles everywhere. And I think this is good to go. But here's, so you just take it up a notch by using the rhinestones. See how I just did those on the front? And then we got the little butterflies right there, little 3D. I'll do the same thing over there and then take a look at the horseshoe, which just kind of ties it all in. And amazing from what it was before to what it is now, right folks? And see.
Totally Dazzled sells sparkling rhinestone wedding supplies. Check us out at totallydazzled.com. But before you do, click up here and download our free printable sparkle quotes. Or click down here and watch one of our other awesome tutorials.